Momentous day for the phenomenal four. That would be us. That is the name of our Leadership Napa Valley Practicum group. My name is Lee W. Miller, and it's my privilege to just welcome our guests, our dignitaries as it were, the director of Leadership Napa Valley and the former mayor of Napa, Jill Teckel. Bruce Barge, he is the board president of the Napa RCD. The Beaver.
Yay!
Yay. Yeah, audible for the Beaver.
Yeah.
Brad Wagenknecht.
Yay!
Supervisor. Rick Thomaser from the Napa County Flood Control. Yay. Rusty Cohn. He is like the unofficial beaver expert. He's taken so many of the great photos that you see on Next Door, and he's also gets photo credit for the photos that are actually on all three signs. And if you were not aware, one sign behind us that we're going to unveil shortly, and then there's another sign on either side of the footbridge right over there. We probably won't see any beavers today simply because they are nocturnal.
So I'm Susan Larson Bauer, and this has been a really, really great project to work on. We're especially excited that we get to finish it.
Yeah.
Leif Bryant and Jeremy Sorrow with the Flood Control District were instrumental in helping us get the signs put together, doing the research. They installed the signs, they poured the concrete and dug those really deep holes. They unfortunately couldn't be here today with us, but I think they deserve a round of applause from all of us. You know, everybody else who had any part in it, who were missing, I'm sorry if we didn't announce your name, but we really appreciate all of your help.
This is rehearsal and the live event.
I'm Katie Anderson. I'm also one of the Phenomenal Four. We started out as a Phenomenal Five. We went down to Phenomenal Four. And if it doesn't start with a PH,
we were going to be the
Phenomenal Four. We don't drink it or eat it.
Yeah,
which didn't rhyme. I'm really pleased to announce our speakers. So I'm going to start first with Brad Wagenknecht and Jill Teckel. If you could say a few words about like what this is all about.
You didn't list the category of someone who's a child of a person in LNV class 34.
Oh, oh okay. Do we have any children of LNV class members in attendance?
So Brad and I have been on the flood board for, I'm no longer, Brad is over
for a moment, yeah.
25 years. And did a lot of the legwork going back and forth to D.C. to get the funding for our project. What we found was, depending upon who was in control back in D.C., we could pitch a different part of the flood control project.
Yes, we could.
So if the Republicans were in control, we could talk about redevelopment and investment.
Business. We were doing business.
But if we were talking to more Democrats than the environmental crowds, we could talk about
the environment, because that's what this is all about.
So I'm especially excited about this project because it's a visual way to show that we really did include the environment in this project. And the other day I had a group of financial investors that were at a conference at the Marriott. They wanted to see a public works project that had transformed a community. I was excited. But as I took them around the riverfront, I had Tracy Schulze with me, and I took a detour over here. And I said, I want you to see, you know, first of all, it's not even unveiled yet. You're seeing it first. But this is what was important to us, was that we have a living river, that nature is part of it, and we are blessed with this beaver colony that just makes it so real to everybody. So I say thank you for handling it and for taking care of this and for doing it and for working out the bureaucratic whose property is where. I always learn a lot. You can hang with them a bit. They've got some lessons learned. And appreciate RCDC and flood control. And I went to see Rick, and Rick said, I'm sometimes known as easy. And I said, Rick, that's good. That's a very good thing.
Depends on what context.
I think I'll move away.
Brad?
You know, I must have been about 10 years, almost 10 years ago, I got an email from Rusty here, and I didn't know Rusty from anything at that point. He said, there's a few of us neighbors that like the beavers in Tuloke Creek. And I said, there are beavers in Tuloke Creek? And so I went down, and sure enough, I saw where the beaver dam was, and a little beaver lodge, Rusty and I have since probably gotten about 800 emails and many, 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 many beaver pictures. And I think I've printed almost all those up so I can have them in my file of beaver stuff. But he really brought beavers clearly to my mind, and I think to a lot of people's mind in the valley. And I think that's part of the reason that we're so excited about the environmental work that we've been able to do. You know, look at this. This is not a LA River flood project. This is trees. This is widening. This is adding access. This is so much more. And now we're telling the story. Thank you.
Thank you. Bruce Bart from Bruce is the board president of Napa Resource Conservation District, RCD.
Yeah.
Can you say a few words?
Of course. So it's an honor for RCD to participate in this. I think the beaver is the perfect example of the kind of work that RCD does, because RCD is committed to following best practice, which beavers definitely do, in sustaining healthy ecosystems. And I thought I would give you some trivia questions about beavers. So, everybody ready?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna go.
So, what country is the beaver the national animal?
Canada.
Yeah.
Canada. I think we should answer.
It's not one of our sites.
We're glad you did some research. And in the United States, there are two states for which the beaver is the state animal. Which two states?
Oregon.
Oregon is one.
Minnesota?
Wisconsin? It's actually New York.
Oh, really? Wow.
Wow.
They killed all their...
I always think of New York beavers. So, the beaver obviously has a very important part in American history. When European settlers first came to America, they estimate that there were 400 million beavers in the United States. Today there's about 15 million. They've made a comeback actually in the last years. So the beaver is an amazing example of the spirit and resourcefulness of our country and of Napa Valley. And again, we're just really proud to support this project.
Napa RCD was our money partner. Not only their expertise, but they were the ones who wrote the check. So we really, really appreciate
Thank
that.
You.
Okay, next up, Richard Thomasert, Napa Flood Control and Water Conservation District Manager.
Yeah, well,
thank you for allowing us to be part of your project. It's really great. I have the most awesome staff, and I feel like I have the best job in the world. I've worked on the flood control project since 2000, thereabouts, and I started out life, I was a hazardous waste cleanup guy, and there were some challenges with hazardous materials on the river, so that's how I got involved with the project, but it kind of morphed into the current job I have, and it's so great to be able to do the kind of restoration work that we do within Napa and then throughout the county. And it's really great to have a great staff of people. Thank kudos to them. They couldn't be here today, but the project turned out awesome, and we're glad to be a part of it.
Last but not least is our mayor, Scott Sedgley, who has...
I got to stand next to the beavers.
All right.
You want to say a couple of words while I get this?
Well, certainly. Rick failed to mention that he had an outstanding board.
Yes, all he does.
The kind of staff, but didn't measure the board, which Brad and I are part of. It's great, and I'm working with the board and Rick on some additional, maybe acquisition of some wetlands that we can expand what we're doing. And that's what it's all about in our county, in our state, and it should be in our nation, in our world, how we address our environmental challenges. But it's great to be part of this, and as mayor now, I've grown lots of files in my office, but I never imagined I'd have a beaver file.
Yeah.
Now that we have a beaver file.
I'm a little jealous.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing. And the first word I'd heard of beaver colonies was at Vintage. At Vintage High School at Salvador Channel, and they were all, the maintenance people were all a rush. What are we going to do? What are we going to do? And so I knew what to do. I mobilized the students. And that is what made the difference. So the beavers are still, as they're moving up and down the channel around Vintage High School, but it's a lot of fun. So I was asked if I could come and read the proclamation. I'm happy to do that. I'm honored to do that. We do a lot of proclamations, and we do ribbon cuttings, and this is my first for beavers, and it's a memorable one. So let's begin. Whereas the entire Napa County community, county cities, and town recognize the long and rich history of beavers, beneficial building within the Napa River watershed. And whereas our valley depends on the health of the Napa River and its tributaries, and the health of the Napa River depends on biological and topological diversity. And whereas the construction of the Napa River flood project helped reestablish beavers within the Napa River watershed. And whereas beavers are keystone species, and their presence in the Napa River and its tributaries also brought back river otters, mink, hawk, ducks, salmon. And whereas we have learned that beavers are not a nuisance species, but are an essential part of the Napa Valley ecosystem and crucial to the biological diversity upon which the Napa River thrives. Therefore, now be it resolved, the beavers are true Napa locals, welcome partners in environmental sustainability, in addition to being cute and fluffy with bright orange teeth and a flappy tail. Now that I, Scott Sedgley, Mayor of the City of Napa, along with the Napa City Council, do hereby recognize the beavers of Napa County for their outstanding engineering efforts benefiting wildlife throughout the Napa River watershed since they were first established. On this day. Okay, so you put your hand here, your paw, like beaver paw. Okay, we're gonna come down. Turn to your left. I'll do this.
Okay.
We're looking. All right. Ready? See, on a count, give us a three count.
One, two, three.
One.
This is a lot more people than I expected.
And we're done in 19 minutes.
Yes.
Nancy has a couple of things to say.
I encourage everybody to go over the footbridge and see the other two signs and come back anytime and enjoy the park.
Thank you very much.
I know.
Basically, have a library. Perfect. But we don't have anything about beavers.
Hobby shop here with a big slot car track. We're all in the slot car. You probably don't know what slot car.
Yeah, I do. I do. I'm
but we're all in the slot car. We swim the pool. They just sweep it in the lake.
She has some contacts there.
Yeah, really.
Beaver dance.
Beaver dance?
Yeah.